guys, real quick, I don't want to keep you here too long considering the length of this video. But if you've been following along the last couple months on our Twitch, then you'll know all about this guy Dennis, aka the Barbecue. This was a collaboration between me and PP Official, and I'm so honored to have worked with them. I did decoy for this catch. I was portraying an 8-year-old girl. Dennis was 59. He turned 60 by the time we confronted him. We confronted him on his 60th birthday. Alex and them drove over like 26 hours just one way to come and catch this guy for the second time. So make sure to go over to their channel or their Instagram and support them and thank them because they drove so far to confront this guy a second time. I mean, it's absolutely insane. This guy was by far the most vile human being I have ever talked to. I am going to put some clips in from the phone calls that I have had with the Barbecue Pred, aka Dennis. I am going to put those phone calls in right before the video starts, just a few clips from the phone calls so you guys can kind of get a feel of what is about to come in this video. Again, Dennis is 60 years old, thinking that he is talking to an 8-year-old, and this would be a second time being confronted by the same organization within just a time frame of a few months. Dennis is from Texas, but he was in Wisconsin for work, ironically. So yeah, we're gonna get into it. Again, thank you so much for being here. I appreciate the support so much, and viewer discretion is advised.
That would look so cute.
Thank you.
You're wearing one of my shirts.
I'll wear one of your shirts if you want.
Yeah, we could probably let you wear one while you're here.
Yeah.
But that's it. Okay.
Oh, like no underwear?
Of course not. You don't wear those, do you? What are you wearing?
A white t-shirt.
A white t-shirt. Okay.
Mom's.
That's cool. That's different.
Yeah.
Is it a thick t-shirt or is it a thin t-shirt?
Thin.
Thin? Better be careful and not get it wet.
I won't.
Because you'd be able to see right through it. Okay. Well, as long as you're not wearing underwear, it's okay.
I'm not. You know
Okay.
I think of you.
Huh?
I said, I'm not. You know I think of you.
Okay. All right. That's a good girl.
Yeah,
and then we're eventually gonna get you where you don't wear them at all. I'm gonna go in for a shower here in just a little bit. I got real dirty today.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, too bad you're not gonna be here to help me though. Oh, you could be a big help to me. But anyway, maybe when you get here. Do I want to lick the wrapper? As long as you're the wrapper.
Yeah.
Okay. I can do that.
Okay.
Starting at your little bitty toes.
Oh, jeez. Here we go.
Or you want me to start at your face?
No. Don't lick my
No.
face.
Or how about your back?
Okay.
Okay. How about your backside?
I don't know.
You'd probably like it. It would probably tickle though, the first time.
Well, yeah.
But I think you'd like it. You got five places it could go.
So I got four, so what's the last one? My ear?
No, you got your mouth.
Yep.
You got your butt.
Yeah.
You got your butt.
Yeah, what's the other one?
And then you got two hands. Yeah. Every time we spin the bottle, either you'd have to kiss me or I'd have to kiss you. Yeah. Put you in a bag, with the barbecue sauce, just your head sticking out. keep you in the closet overnight. Then you should be good and tender in the morning.
Hey, it's his 16th birthday! Where's 16 days? Hey, you know how old the fan is? Civil Rock plays it even thick with you before I know you. Hey, thanks for being with us for so long. Yeah, man. Hey, sweetie, you want to open that present for him?
Yeah.
All right, let's see. Wait, give me an idea of building plans. All right, now, sounds good. All
right, let's get to it.
All right, now. Here, hold the cake, son. There you go. All right.
This is great. We really appreciate you.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, what are you?
I got your ass. Where was it? You remember?
It was in Midland.
Not Midland. Try again. 35 South.
Oh, yeah. It's in Cotulla,
Texas.
Yeah.
1,500 miles away. I drove that far to get your ass. So, I'm going to ask you, we had every single message saved. I'm sure you remember how this goes because it wasn't too long ago.
Yeah.
So, who were you talking to? Who is this girl you were talking to on the phone for the last few, however long?
Well, she said her name was Melanie.
Correct. Okay. And before we get into messages, how old was Melanie?
16.
Correct. Yeah. So, being that you've been caught before for this, why the hell were you talking to another minor?
Because I'm a dumbass.
Because you're a dumbass.
Yeah.
I think it's more than a dumbass.
Yeah. Why were you talking to a minor?
Well, she actually started. She followed me and started.
So why
talking.
Were you talking
matter.
To
doesn't
a
matter.
Minor?
Why were you talking to her?
Yeah, I shouldn't.
So why were you talking to a minor?
Because I screwed up.
Okay.
Again.
So were the contents of this sexual? Yes or no?
Yeah, a lot of it was.
Okay. So again, we confronted you for the same thing. First time it was a 7 and a 13-year-old. Now it's an 8-year-old. So. You see, and there's no debating this, there's a pattern of you talking to underage kids, yes or no? Okay, so, last time you told me you weren't that P word, Now, this time, there's no excuse of getting out of what you are, correct?
I need to get some help.
Okay, so, you told me a different answer in March, but would you say that you are a pedophile, Dennis? Because you did send to us, right?
Multiple times.
Okay. And last time, you said, oh, it was just someone from Germany that sent it to me. But this time, you sent us multiple photos of CP.
Yeah.
So, there's no bullshitting us this time.
Yeah.
So, at this point, you would say that you are correct, yes or no?
I would say that.
Okay. Alright. Why'd you lie to me the first time about that?
Well, I didn't want to admit that I was to myself.
Okay. So, when did you start to notice that you were a pedophile?
About a year ago? Yeah.
I think you've been on Instagram longer than a year, Dennis.
Yeah, I have. But...
Which means you've been following underage kids for longer than a year.
You can go wherever you want, by the way. Whatever's good for you.
Okay. Well, I mean, I follow back anybody that follows me, pretty much.
Okay, so if the last time you told me you weren't too, well, and on phone calls, you weren't too fond of the marginalized groups. So if a gay fan page followed you, would you follow it back in?
Actually, there are a couple of gay people and there's a fan page following.
Yeah, but you don't like
them. But you don't follow them back?
Yeah. I can't remember the name. I think it's Andrea.
I think you're full of it. But we're gonna get into the messages. And we're gonna get into the punch of the phone call. So no, this is the girl you were attracted to. This picture is clearly so underage. There is no rationalizing being attracted to her, wouldn't you say? So before we get into the message, what would you say? What about this face attracted you to it? What about this face wanted you to get her naked? What about this face wanted you to do stuff with her, which you did admit to, all on the call. We have everything recorded and saved. What about this face turned you on? What about this face made you stroke your on the phone? What about this face made you want to take off her clothes and do the nastiest shit to her? What about this face, was it?
I have no idea.
You need to answer this time.
Well, I have,
you need to answer this time.
I don't understand. I really don't understand.
Because you're sexually attracted to children. That's what it is.
Yep.
So just say that instead of saying I don't know. Just say that.
I guess I am.
So what about a child sexually attracts you?
I don't know. I really don't know.
There has to be something. Like, for example, on a girl I like her lips or an ass. So those attract me, and I don't see an issue with saying that. So what about an underage girl?
Maybe
says?
It's the innocence.
The innocence?
Yeah, maybe.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Honestly, I really don't know.
Okay. Yeah. So what about a second grader's innocence? And that is a second grader. And if Melanie was an idiot, she'd be a first grader. So really a first grader. What about a first grader's innocence turns you on?
I can't put a finger. I don't know. I guess I need help. You know, I'm sure I need
something.
Help. Yeah. I don't know. I really don't.
There's kids on that phone right now, dude.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. That kid is probably 8 years old. Probably is 8 years old. I mean, super, super young. I can't comprehend. And you wanted to go in that very pool with the kid. Okay, so we have all these messages of you saved. You've texted quite a lot over the past few months. What did you say, Dennis?
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to get right into these.
Well, I already
listened. Well, you're going to listen.
Yeah, you're going to listen. And it's been, I know it's been longer than a year, because you talked about wrestling with your neighbor's underage kids, which we'll get to later, too. This time, you cannot bring this. You can't do it, Dennis. Okay. So, you also talked about putting barbecue sauce on this 8-year-old girl.
That was a joke.
It was a joke?
But you talked about it every single night.
Talked about it. Yeah.
You said you wanted to put her in a bath full of barbecue sauce. You wanted to marinate her body in a bag full of barbecue sauce.
Well, that was...
You want to put barbecue sauce on her private area and lick it off?
Here, Dennis, what we're going to do is we're going to go sit over there.
Okay.
We're gonna go sit over there. We're gonna get away from the cage. Okay. Did you have to get the present? Chris? Go ahead and run. Good. Okay. So, typically, when a guy's meeting up for a sexual encounter, they talk about wearing a condom, not condiments. So what made you, besides being a what made you want to do, what made you want to wear a condom mints instead of a condom?
I meant it as a joke. It was supposed to be funny.
Is this a joke though?
No.
Yeah,
why you said that?
Yeah. Yeah, you said dick pic. What flavor was a dick pic? With barbecue sauce on it? Sweet baby or what?
Why did you say that it tastes like cottage cheese?
No, that's the thing.
Why did you say it though?
Cottage cheese. I said I don't know what it tastes like.
Okay. You've been talking to me for 2 months. Yeah. I know everything you said.
We'll get into it. So, you know what we did? We got you sweet baby Melanie's, which you also joked about. Yeah. So, what we're going to do, well, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Cool. All right, here we go. So, you know that take a shot game? Simulate that with barbecue sauce.
Well, I'm liable to throw up here.
Huh?
Good.
You
might put it back up a little bit if it starts coming.
I don't care. Yeah. I would wipe your puke all over my face as a sign of victory.
Okay.
So you said you want to have some fun tonight. Like what? Just be a little naughty. And you said, I'm very excited. And you said, are you ready to get a little bit naughty or no? I'd say that's cool, wouldn't you? Go ahead. Okay. All right, it's a swing.
It wasn't coming out.
Oh, is that what you're bubbling in there? Is that what you say in bed with your 8-year-olds?
No.
Okay. All right. Anyway, so why did you want to get just a little naughty with an 8-year-old girl? And this is, pass me that chair. And this is before.
Behind you. Yeah, there's no way.
And this is, before you even said really nasty stuff. So what do you mean by, do you want to get a little bit naughty, Dennis? And like I said, every question I ask you, I know. So go ahead and answer.
Go on.
Play, I guess. I don't know.
Like what?
I really don't know.
What did you have? What did you try having her do on the phone that night?
Oh, I had tried to have
her.
Okay.
And that is cool, right? So that's illegal. I think you just like barbecue sauce.
You
I don't think you're really
hammer.
I do like barbecue sauce.
Well,
I
know. We can tell.
Yeah,
I know.
We know.
Anyway. But why did you want her to touch herself?
Yeah, that's not very innocent. You said you like her because of her innocence. Why did you want her to touch herself?
Yeah, exactly.
See if she did it.
Okay, and if she did it, that would have gotten you. And like you said, because you are attracted, you did admit you were if she did it, that would have gotten you like turned on, right? Yes or no? Okay. So what about an 8-year-old touching herself turned you on? Because from the stuff you sent, it was similar content. It was an underage kid doing stuff, right? So that didn't turn me on. In fact, that made me go, oh, hell no. That made me, that has a knee-jerk reaction to just make me, oh my God. Like, that disgusts me, dude. I've been doing this for 2 years, and I don't get grossed out at the stuff y'all say at all anymore.
Yeah.
But even just sending crap like that, that disgusts me. It's weird. So when every other citizen on Earth, and you know, I'm not saying if they jump off a cliff, would you know, this is something that both sides of the aisle can agree on, that really is bad. So what makes you be the outcast and get hard to an 8-year-old touching herself? What about that turns you on?
I really don't know. I get, you know, I need to get help. That way I can find out what it is.
But if my cameraman touches himself, I think it's gross. I don't want to watch that. So there's something that grosses you out. There's something that turns you on. If I were to send you a video of me doing this, you wouldn't want to watch it, right?
Right.
So what makes you want to watch the one with the 8-year-old? There has to be something, dude.
Female.
Female? Yeah, but most people's age limit is 18.
Why 8?
Yeah, why 8? Well, why the 8-year-old female? Why the underdeveloped female?
Underdeveloped.
I don't know. Maybe it's what I would do.
What
did
you
do
as a kid?
I was molested by an older adopted sister.
Really?
Okay.
For over a year.
All right. Why repeat the cycle?
I don't know.
All right. Then nobody cares that you were molested. Okay.
No,
I'm trying to find that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
It was pretty horrible to you, right?
At first, yeah. But
after. I mean, you definitely do seem like the type that has no problem with doing stuff with the sister. I mean, just listen to yourself and look at yourself. But
I was
6 years old. So you were going to meet a 7-year-old the first time, 8-year-old this time, and it was pretty bad to be touched. That it's horrible to, like, that's horrible, right? So what made, knowing how bad it is, what made you want to repeat this cycle?
I can't give you an answer.
You gotta start answering her questions.
Well,
here.
I'm trying, okay?
All right.
You know, if I don't have an answer, you don't know. Okay, I don't know what the drive is. It's definitely I need to get help.
Why haven't you gotten help yet if you've known of this? I mean, you sent CP to who you thought was an 8-year-old for over 2 months now. You think that you would have recognized that you needed help. You don't care that you need help.
No.
You're just selfish for your own pleasure. That's where the problem is, dude.
And you also talked about this Kayla girl you dated. You talked about her the first time. You said she was 21?
20. Yeah, she was 18 when I met her. She's 20, she'll be 21 in November.
Sure, I think that's BS, but you know, I'm not too focused on that. But you mentioned one of the first phone calls. Turn the bottle this way, by the way.
Thank you. There you go.
You mentioned during your phone calls, one of the first things was that you hate the concept of cheating, because this 8-year-old was describing how the dad cheated, right?
Yeah.
You hate the concept of cheating, you said cheating's wrong, and your Instagram was just filled with stuff for Kayla.
Yeah.
I doubt Kayla even knew who you were, but anyway, filled with stuff for Kayla. But then, not too long, it took you to say, I wanted to help me get my back clean, or back bath brush thingy. You started sending pee-pee pics to her. You started talking all this. So, why'd you give a nice lecture of virtue signaling about loyalty, and then proceed to do this a week later?
Like 3 days later.
3 days later.
Answer, what?
I don't know. Stupid.
Right, but, you know, you gave this lecture on loyalty when you previously cheated on Kayla with a 7 and a 13-year-old. So, clearly, you don't really care about cheating. Is part of the reason why you gave this 8-year-old a lecture on cheating to get her more comfortable, you think?
No. I don't. I've been cheated on before in a relationship, and no, I really don't like cheating.
So why did you cheat on Kayla?
Kayla and I are broke.
You weren't at the time, though. So you were talking to me.
Yeah.
I know everything about you.
Yeah.
You guys were not broken up. So just answer that simple question.
Very shortly after that, we were broken up.
Right.
Why did y'all break up?
She went back to her ex-boyfriend.
I don't think Kayla's even real. All right. So you said whoever wants to help volunteer. So when you talked about having a bath brush, someone to wipe your back, I guess, you were talking about Melanie when you said someone far away.
Probably Kayla
at that time.
Why did you say, do you know anyone that would want to help them? If you knew who you were talking about. That was Kayla.
I have something to say, you know.
Yeah.
Then you said, now I'm thinking that there might be two that would help. So Kayla was one of them, and Melanie was probably the second one, right? When you said,
yeah.
All right. So, what made you want an 8-year-old? Yeah. Why'd you want an 8-year-old to brush your back?
Well, can't reach it.
Okay. Maybe you would, but you'd probably have to keep your eyes closed. And she says, I would. Why? Because I wouldn't have clothes on.
Put your phone down.
Put it away.
Okay.
Because I wouldn't have clothes on. I'd say not having clothes on around an 8-year-old girl. What's the penalty for that?
Probably jail.
Well, yeah, but it's called indecent exposure.
Yeah.
Like, kind of like how your skin with the sun, indecent exposure to the sun. But indecent exposure in 8-year-olds.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's pretty cool to me, so. Okay. So why did you want to get a massage from an 8-year-old with your clothes on?
I already told you, I definitely got a problem.
Do you think wanting a massage with an 8-year-old would lead to a happy ending?
That wasn't the intention. Okay.
But it was.
But all the other ones, that was the intention.
Well, no,
just
I
not
mean,
this one.
Well, no.
Right,
I mean,
okay.
You know, back hurts, you know. Back massage just feels good.
Right, my back hurts too, but I'm not going to ask that 8-year-old boy to rub my back.
Yeah, is it weird to have an 8-year-old go 1,500 miles to rub your back? And that's before we even get to the real And then you sent this photo of you where you have your tongue out like this. What was the point of that?
You said come here. For what? Here. So you're talking about, you said come here. You're talking about how there's a thunderstorm. You said that you're feeling really affectionate.
No.
Why are you telling an 8-year-old that you're really affectionate when there's a thunderstorm?
Because I do get affectionate when there's a thunderstorm.
You said
why
it puts me in a special mood. But why are you telling an 8-year-old that? Who cares if you get affectionate if there's a thunderstorm? Why are you talking to an 8-year-old like that? But why?
I'm already answered that. I have got it in.
Okay. Then you said, I like thunder and lightning. that. For some reason, it makes me feel affectionate. It puts me in a special mood. And you did have a tendency. See, this whole page, it was only you texting besides her at the end right here. So you were pretty clingy to this 8-year-old yes or no.
Yeah, I got that.
And you did say I love you to her, right?
Yeah.
And I'm not saying you're in love now, because obviously you know she's not real, but you did fall in love at some point, right? Yes or
to
no?
Certain
point,
yeah.
Is it weird to fall in love with an 8-year-old?
Yeah, the attention.
The attention it was?
She barely gave you any, except on the phone.
Right.
And we were live streaming.
Yeah.
I mean, we're giving you attention right now. Do you love us?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, I'm sure you do.
And you say, good morning, sweetie. Missed you last night. And then you send a rose.
You said, I dreamed that you fell asleep lying on top of me and I was hugging you.
Did you dream about that? Well, you just said that's kind of making me comfortable, right?
Yeah.
Do you know the process of getting an underage kid comfortable? Do you know what that's called? Grooming. You'd say you did a fair amount of grooming here, right?
I would say yes.
And you know, but the thing is, you've been touched before. You know how bad it can be. I don't know how bad it can be. I haven't been touched. I can't speak for them, but you know how bad the process. You know how bad it is. You know how evil it is. Why do it? And you talk about your love for Jesus Christ, man. You talked about Jesus, man.
That's surprising.
Then you talked about your hatred for Muslims. But you're the one dating an underage kid, wanting to marry her and fall in love. I'd say you're a lot more like the one you hate than the one that you claim to worship. What did you say, Dennis?
Yeah, probably. Yeah.
So why is that? Why do you have this whole fake thing going on? Do you even know your true identity? You talk about being loyal. You're not loyal. You talk about being a Christian. But then you act like the one you said you don't like. I mean, do you even know yourself at this point? It's been 60 years, Dennis.
I know, I probably don't.
Where were you born?
Where was I born?
Yep.
I was born in Texas.
You said, your Facebook said Dickinson.
Yeah.
Dickinson.
Dickinson is the town I lived in. I was born in Texas.
Oh, okay. Well, your hometown should really be called Dick and Daughter instead of Dick and Son, because you always want to fuck someone's underage daughter. Would you say that's a fair assessment, Dennis?
Yeah.
All right. Hey, cutie. How is your day going? Where's my little princess? Time for a shower. Seems you do a lot of sunbathing. Why do you don't take a shower? Take another bath. All right.
So I wish you were here. I could use about an hour of play wrestling.
I can tell you wrestle.
You should wrestle now.
Yeah. Who do you wrestle with? The WSA, the World Starvation Organization?
Pretty good.
Association. Yeah. Pretty good wrestler. Okay. All right. Anytime you want. Are we going to have rules or does anything go? Like, is tickling okay? Why do you want to tickle and wrestle an 8-year-old? Because it turns you on?
Yeah, be more specific. You're answering questions here.
I guess it
does. I'd say wrestling with a girl's pretty sexual. I mean, it gets me turned on.
You know what to do, man.
I should have a drink. Alright. This could be really fun.
What do you need dinner tonight?
No, of course not. I'm sure the cheese they serve at the jail is not that good. Okay, then you send this picture of two underage kids doing gymnastics. So we notice with a lot of you people as in, you follow these underage girl gymnastics pages. There's something about the gymnastics, like we catch a lot of the people from these gymnastics pages. What about underage gymnastics turns you on? Is it like they're flexible so they show like their private parts are like visible and stuff like that?
It's athletic. You know, the strength and the athleticism, flexibility.
Okay. Yeah. Is flexibility a turn on for you?
To a certain extent.
Okay. So when you see an underage girl doing flexible things, you somehow, that's a turn on for you?
To an extent, yeah. I'll be honest with you, yeah.
Okay. Why is that though?
I can't give you an answer. I don't know. I don't know what causes.
So do you watch the Junior Olympics with a napkin and some lube?
No, I don't watch the Olympics.
Okay. Fair point, I don't even know. Okay. Then you said, cuddle up with me then. We can go back to sleep. And then you said, oh, well, then she said, oh, what else besides cuddle? We could kiss maybe, but we wouldn't sleep if we did. That could lead to a different kind of wrestling. What is that different kind of wrestling?
You said the kind of wrestling with no clothes on.
Yeah.
You know what to do.
Oh, it sounds pretty to me. Take a shot.
We're celebrating.
Yeah, that's your birthday, Dennis.
Yeah.
Come on.
Plus, you talked about that. You said you wanted sweet baby.
Yeah, he literally did. So, literally, we're doing him a favor.
We spent so much money on you. $100 for the ink for this. I mean, they traveled so far for this.
Yeah, it's more than your wife ever did, right?
Pretty
much, yeah. All right, but anyway, you also sent to this girl, and it wasn't just somebody from Germany. Like you said the first time, you sure had a lot of this.
It was all from Telegram.
Yep. Oh, Telegram's the app where you people go on. You said he sent, right?
Yeah.
Oh. I guess you have
that
a
cake that you sent. The next slide was. Don't play stupid.
You said so much you don't even remember?
Yeah, you did send so much, actually.
Yeah. Okay, so you lied about the first time. You said that was the only photo you had. That's obviously not true.
At the time, yes.
Okay, so since March, when you got caught, when you claimed you said you would never do this again, you know, it was 4 a.m. when we caught you, you remember?
Yeah,
and we did a catch in Austin before that, so we drove 3 hours, and we had the cops involved in Austin, and we, you know, we were in San Antonio, so we, you know, you were like 100 miles away from San Antonio, give or take. You're so lucky that we were all about to crash and just fall asleep. God, somehow you got a saving grace, because you were sicker than the guy in San Antonio, or I'm sorry, the guy in Austin. So, since you got caught and said you'd never do this again, what made you acquire more on your phone?
Well, the guy that I got the other from told me where he got it from.
Okay, so that means you were interested in viewing porn yesterday.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why
are you
sending it to an 8-year-old, though? That was the first time I ever saw porn, and you kept me up so much. Yeah, you sick son of a bitch.
Yeah, so.
Oh, it's spicy.
Also, porn is obviously something you create to. So.
At times, yeah.
You created to the. I know you did it at least once, but you did it quite a few times, just so you know.
Don't flip me out. Yeah.
Okay. So, you know, possessing is illegal. Soliciting a minor is illegal. Showing your in front of a minor is illegal. Viewing porn is illegal. Masturbating too, it's a whole other level of sick. I mean, Jesus Christ. So, what turns you on? I mean, obviously, you like older girls too, right?
Yeah.
Right, so you're not one of those that only likes underage. There's never an excuse, like, you know. So what? Why don't you just, and as evil as it is, you know, I shouldn't have to lecture you because you're a Jesus lover. You should know that porn is sinful and evil. But I shouldn't have to lecture you on how evil porn is. Porn is destructive. Porn is evil. If you watch it, please stop watching. But why can't you just look up? If you're going to be a cuckold who has no self-respect for himself, why don't you just look that up when it's an adult? But why?
Curious, because this guy's fan it was all over the place, and so, yeah, I...
So you had it the first time, too, so why again, though?
Well, I got it from the same guy that told me where he got it from.
Why were you curious, though?
Telegram, huh? Yeah, why were you curious?
Because I didn't think that there was, like, what there is there. I mean, go on Telegram. Seriously.
No, we're good.
Oh, I understand what's on there. Yeah. So, you were more than just curious because you said you masturbated to it more than once, yes or no?
Yeah.
So, something brought you back that you were more than just curious. Yeah. Clearly, you were attracted to it. Clearly, you liked it, had pleasure towards it. I mean, why, dude?
If I knew that, then I'd be able to stop it.
You'd be able to stop it?
Yeah.
You know, I used to be, I don't do it anymore. I mean, I can stop that. Is there something, like, with underage kids? Because when I was in high school, I used to watch, and I stopped it. I mean, I don't understand. I mean, because I'm attracted to big kids, whatever. And I used to watch that. But, and I was able to stop it. So I don't understand, why aren't you able to stop it? You're just attracted to kids. That doesn't mean you can't just stop doing this and stop looking it up.
Well, I think it's a form of mental illness, to be honest with you.
Well, then you should probably get help for it.
Absolutely.
You're right.
It shouldn't have to take this, you know, your second time for you to be like, whoa, I probably need help.
Anyway, could be fun to put you over my knees and give you a couple of pats on your little butt. So you wanted to spank her.
Her bare butt too, you mentioned multiple times. Why?
That's kind of one of the things I like with
females.
No, females, period.
Oh, okay, it's like one of your turn-ons?
Yeah.
Sounds cool to me.
You know what to do?
A little sweet, huh?
Yeah.
Don't you like it though?
Yeah, I probably won't be after today.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, us too.
Okay, I'll think of something, maybe a bare butt spanking. There it is. Okay. You sent. Oh, dude, what the fuck is this? You sent a picture, not nude, of an underage kid sleeping on the chest of a.
Grown ass.
Of a grown man.
Yeah, grown ass man. You said I want some. You said I want to sleep like that.
You wanted, yeah, you said you want this.
Okay.
That's cool. It's not CP. You said you wanted this.
Yeah.
And this represents. How the fuck do you have that saved on your phone? This represents an adult male with someone that looks to be 8 years old cuddling, right?
That could have been just a father daughter type thing. I don't know.
Your daughter?
That is so messed up.
No,
that's
even
more messed
up.
I mean,
wow.
Because you sent so many of these, dude.
You don't remember it, but I mean, it's right here. So.
Yeah, well, I see that. Yeah.
So you use this word naughty a lot with her. Is the word naughty a turn on for you? Like when you call someone naughty, does that just get you in the mood?
No, I just, instead of using anything more graphic.
But why do you care about being graphic or not graphic? I mean, you were graphic enough for us to drive 1,500 miles to get you.
Yeah.
So, I thought about going straight from the shower to cuddle in bed without putting on clothes. You also took a lot of shower photos of her.
A lot. You said that would be kind of naughty. Sorry about that. Hope you're not mad. And you're like, do you think you would like that? Why are you asking her if she would like that, though? Answer a question.
Again, you know, that I got an issue. I got a problem.
Okay.
Whatever.
Good. We're going to have lots of fun. I hope you're ready. That's my good little girl. It's going to be a fun call. So you did offer to have fun. All right.
Baby.
Well.
Yeah.
You were stroking to her.
Oh, no, not all the time.
Okay,
well, let's talk about. Go ahead.
When you told me to pull up my shirt and spread my legs and start touching myself, you weren't trying to have phone sex there?
There I was.
Okay.
Then yes.
So phone sex with an 8 year old. And you were also stroking your cock when you were talking to your Afghan vet son on the phone. He's suffering with PTSD. You were stroking your cock and showing pictures to an 8 year old.
These are actually the pictures from it. All of these are. From that phone call.
Okay.
Explain that one.
I can't.
Can't explain anything, can you? Just like the first time.
Both of you had PTSD. He has PTSD from Afghanistan, you have PTSD patting the small. Same time. Is that a father son thing? Like it was a father daughter thing? Okay. It's gonna be a fun call. Fuck you. Fuck you, man. I'm going to see if I can make you blush. Are you you're perpetually blushing from the sun? Yeah.
Well, I've been sun all day.
Yeah, you kind of look like someone that would be on a commercial for like melanoma or something. Okay, good. We're going to have lots of fun then. I hope you're ready. You always talk about fun and being naughty with her. You really like. There's something about snatching innocence that you like. You talked about touching your neighbor's daughter on the phone, and that was a bit. So. Take me through the beginning. Take me through the grooming process with her. Take me through when it happened. And take me through if they found out or not. So start. How did you meet this neighbor's daughter?
No, I didn't actually meet this neighbor's daughter.
That's still weird to be creeping on some kids. So you were at least creeping on her, right?
What the hell is wrong with you, dude? So when you guys were wrestling and you got turned on?
No.
But you wanted to do stuff with her, so why wouldn't you get turned on? If I was wrestling with someone that I found was hot, I would get turned on. Why wouldn't you get turned on?
I never did. They would jump on me and all three of them.
All three.
Did you say one was seven?
Yeah,
9, 7. Hey, can one of y'all get me Melanie's paper over there? Is it up there?
That's in the box.
In the box. So 9, 7, and 4?
Yeah.
Okay. So, and again, so this, obviously your age, 7, you went after that. You wanted to meet up with a 7-year-old. So, and I'm not saying you're as attracted to this one as 7 and 9. I understand it's a whole different animal here.
Yeah.
But was a 4-year-old mildly attractive to you, yes or no?
No.
Oh, boy. Okay. But what about a girl, though? Would a 4-year-old girl... And I'm not saying she's as attractive as, like, you know...
An 8-year-old.
Like, double the age, just older. Or, like, an 18-year-old. But toddlers don't turn you on?
No.
Okay. So the limit for you, obviously, 7 you had no problem with. What about 6? 6 isn't really a toddler.
So the limit is 7 years old? 7. That's the youngest you've
got? Lucky number 7. Unlucky number 7, I
should say. Like I say, it was about the age that...
Yeah, so a first grader. Kindergarten is just too young. But as soon as they reach number grades, you're suddenly fair game to you.
Yeah.
But yeah, absolutely.
Now, like I say, that was about the time that I got started being.
True.
So,
I guess I don't understand. You someone after it happening to you is like a Jew becoming Hitler and wanting to commit another genocide. So why is that?
Well, I don't know. I understand that happens quite a bit. That it carries on. I have read about it.
Yeah, it does.
You know, trying to figure out how to figure out something about it.
I mean, when you were your first kid, did you feel bad about it?
I haven't.
Oh, okay. I'm going to call bullshit on that. But you're still committing child abuse when you do stuff like this. And when you view children, you understand that, right? Because these people that make they're sick. Yeah, but they want to make money. So when you contribute to that market, when you have a market for something, which you contribute to, which you pay to, I'd say it's even worse. You contribute to the abuse of children.
Yeah. And you pay for it. And those children are like being trafficked, like human trafficked.
Yeah, you take pleasure.
To
you're too much of a bitch to actually do it, it seems.
I haven't paid.
But you still give it popularity and money by doing it. You contribute to it. You literally get off to children having their innocence robbed, to them being trafficked, to them having their life ruined. I mean, what's the difference between you being turned on by that and somebody being turned on by, say, a murder happening? I mean, both are someone's innocence being taken away. I mean, if someone says, I get off on killing people, I think that's just as bad as someone that gets off on seeing kids abused. Because you literally get off on that. You do. You really do. So say it. I get off on kids being abused.
I have.
Say it.
Say it.
I have.
If it's true, say it.
I have gotten off on kids being abused.
Okay. Now wash that dirty-ass mouth off with some Sweet Baby Ray's.
You go
on. No, we don't have them chug. We got many more chests to go, you see. Okay. So let's see what you wanted to do and how, you know, enough with this negative talk. Let's talk about the barbecue sauce. Yeah, barbecue. Alright, so you talked about barbecue sauce for a sex act. You talked about a
multiple sex acts,
you know.
On a kid.
Yeah. So you talked about lathering her up in barbecue sauce.
Marinating her in
barbecue 8-year-old ribs.
Yeah.
I should say. Why? It's obviously a turn off for you. It is. You wouldn't talk about it this much if it was a joke. I didn't hear any laughter on the phone call. I didn't.
The laughing was me.
Right. So a condiment isn't just something with underage kids. This is in general. I've never heard of a condiment.
You know, chocolate syrup, things like that. Yeah.
Okay.
Never done anything like that. Whipped cream.
Yeah, but whipped cream is in barbecue sauce.
And even
I don't even know how
condiment,
the
Yeah, but people that use whipped cream and chocolate syrup don't say that they want to put someone's body in a bag and marinate them in it. Yeah, that's a little extreme, don't you think?
Yeah. Barbecue 8-year-old?
That was actually...
Was that a joke, too?
That was actually meant like that, because I wouldn't do that.
Yes, I understand. That's fair to say that you wouldn't actually put her in a bag and marinate it, but the thought turns you on, right? We've caught someone that said he wants to put a 13-year-old in a dungeon. Obviously, there's no dungeon to put the 13-year-old into, but you would say it's a fantasy.
Yeah.
Okay. So what about seeing this face in a bag and marinating it turns you on?
You just said it was a fantasy. No, marinating someone in barbecue sauce, yeah, just probably would be, I
can understand the fetish. I can understand the fetish. I mean, we're grilling you right now with barbecue sauce, so I mean, I understand. I can relate.
Yeah.
All right. You also wanted to come on a fruit cup.
And have her eat it.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's a good point.
Getting used to it.
Yeah. So, by coming on a fruit cup, which fruit was it specifically that you wanted to come on?
Fruit cup.
Oh, fair enough. So, what about that turned you on with an 8-year-old?
I don't know.
Have you done this fruit cup act before with the girl? Not under 8.
An adult? Yeah.
So, what about that turned you on with the adult?
That she was eating it.
She was eating it?
She knew she was eating it.
I've never seen a straight guy be so fruity. But you also said you want to piss on this 8-year-old. You did say that. You want to pee on her.
I probably
didn't
say that.
Right.
I remember saying it.
So
why
do you
want
to pee on her?
Another one of the things that...
Look me in the eyes. Why did you want to pee on her?
Another one of those things that I've done in the past. You know?
So why do you want to do it to an 8-year-old?
Same thing. I got an issue. I've got a problem.
Claramente, you have an issue. And you wanted to plan on doing this in the shower, right, I presume?
Well, yeah. Where you could do that.
So how do you think an 8-year-old would feel after her little experience with you? Because you also talked about doing this back when you come to Texas, right?
Yeah.
So this long-term relationship you were going to have with this 8-year-old, how do you think she would feel after getting pissed on by you?
Probably not good.
How did you feel after getting pissed by your sister? After comprehending what was going on?
After that, I kind of enjoyed it. To be perfectly honest with you, a certain extent. You know, you started out, didn't like it, but, you know.
Okay, you are really mentally ill.
But you feel damaged by it now, right?
I think it has affected me,
It has affected me.
And I don't think an 8-year-old girl would be... The fact that you enjoyed it, that's one in... I've never heard of an abuse victim enjoying it. But you would say it would affect her too, right? Having her innocence taken away 1,500 miles away from home, being pissed on in barbecue sauce. I mean, that's basically just bullying her.
Yeah, and you wanted to eat her ass. Wouldn't you feel bad for this kid?
Yeah.
This innocent little girl. My niece is 7 years old, dude. You're talking to someone a year older than her, saying that you want to piss on her and eat her ass.
And trust me, we want you to eat her, believe me, but not from an 8-year-old girl's ass. So, seems kind of cool to me. So what's the motive behind eating this 8-year-old girl's ass? Like, you fantasize about this, because we know you've been to Melanie before, yes or no?
Well, I already told you.
Yes. But to her specifically, Melanie specifically.
Yeah, that's what I told
you. I can conceptualize this because I know who this is. Granted, this is a picture in the face app, but you to this. You to this. So, Melanie specifically, and not on the phone, have you fantasized about Melanie a few times when you were calling her? And I know you've done it once. How many times, and I know it's more than one, have you prayed to Melanie when you weren't on the phone with her?
Was it when you said you, dreamt about her?
Probably.
And now's the time to be honest. Did you And it's okay. I mean, at this point, we're just being honest.
Yeah.
We're working with each other here, right?
Yeah.
So, at some point, did you, with the barbecue sauce, did you to putting the barbecue sauce on Melanie at some point? Yes or no?
No.
All right. So, what would you fantasize about with her that made you?
They're trying to...
Eating her ass? Is that one of them or no?
Well, probably, yeah. Probably.
Okay.
Peeing on her, is that one of them?
No.
Holy crap, man. You inadvertently wrote a whole book. You know right now in the chat, we're only on June 23rd.
What?
You know in the chat right now, we're only on June 23rd? I mean, you were obsessed.
And I mean,
her.
We skipped May.
Absolutely.
We just did the worst.
Yeah.
You were obsessed.
So do you know what do apart? Do you know what a boy looks like with his clothes off? She said no. So she didn't even know what a looked like. And you destroyed her innocence by showing her
this.
That. And then you said, not even pictures. Well, you will when we take a shower together. So you were going to destroy your innocence in the shower.
You feel bad. That's an 8-year-old. You feel bad.
Yes, I do. And not just because you're here.
She's still
in
the pool. No. Yeah. It's an 8-year-old, man. It's an 8-year-old. I don't wear clothes in the shower, do you?
If you want to wash it, you can do that too. Meaning what?
Okay. So why did you want her to wash your...
Because I have issues. I already told you.
No. Because...
Why not your girl? Does that turn you on then? The thought of an 8-year-old washing your... Does that
turn you on? Surely it does.
Well,
no, it does a lot. I mean, you've sent pictures a lot.
So. Well, yeah. I heard the word turn on. All right. Hey, Chris. We're going to eat after this. Can you order the fried pickles?
Yeah, for sure.
For sure.
Wait.
Yeah, no, Chris. Order fried pickles. Yeah, I know. Hey,
just order
the fried pickles.
They're pretty good.
Okay. Dude, yeah, just order the fried pickles over there. So don't, you know, just...
Yeah. In the parking lot.
Yeah. Okay. Well, one was just sweet and you had very good dreams. You said one was just sweet and nice. We just laid in bed eating junk food, cuddling, and watching TV till we fell asleep. All right.
And the other one was kind of naughty, but lots of fun. I said, oh, what, like what? You're like, let's just say we had chocolate syrup and we had fun with it. And then you sent 3 tongue emojis.
Yeah. You were going to Hershey's Kiss an 8-year-old, which is legal. So what about chocolate syrup on an 8-year-old turns you on?
The chocolate syrup thing.
Let me see how much is in here, though. Ooh.
I got blank.
Oh, you do. Yeah.
All right, take another swig because, I mean...
Chocolate syrup. I mean, that looks similar to chocolate syrup, wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
All right. It was fun in the dream. You seem to really like it. You said really in all caps. People really do that in real life. Some do. Some do with things that are kind of different. I can understand why someone would do that. It feels good to be licked, and chocolate syrup is good. So you didn't want to lick this 8-year-old, you know?
Yeah.
Cool.
You said, is that something you might want to do? I know you would love it when you do it. It's f***ed up, dude. I would make sure that you love it, too. Maybe we can try barbecue sauce, too.
Then I could eat you all up. So this barbecue sauce fantasy, have you put barbecue sauce on a female before? Yes or no?
No.
Okay.
Chocolate syrup, whipped cream, chocolate pudding, yeah.
Okay. So you've never had really the sour condiments.
Right.
Happy birthday, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah.
How long are you going to sing the song?
Oh.
Should we do it in Spanish?
Yeah. We also heard what you said about my hardworking Mexicans right here.
You like Mexicans a lot, so.
Yeah. Okay, yes. Sing it. Sing it, Beans. Go ahead.
Oh, we don't know it.
Sing it. Sing
we
it.
Don't know. We don't know what to say.
What?
We should know Feliz Cumpleaños.
All right.
Feliz Cumpleaños, gringo.
Thank you.
What kind of Mexicans are you guys?
The whitewash
ones. From Wisconsin, I guess.
like my cousin.
Yeah, like those ones.
Yeah, he got adopted when he was 11 months old.
Oh, yeah, so did he.
I'm actually raised by white parents.
Oh. Yeah, well, that's the way my cousin was. And when he got into high school, he lived in San Antonio.
From San Antonio.
Oh, yeah. Well, he lived in San Antonio, and he got the crap beat out of him all the time.
Oh, my God, so did Spanish. He. Because
he couldn't speak Spanish.
Yeah,
we did all the time, man.
Yeah, actually.
He got stuffed in lockers and all that for being
here. Hey, make sure you're getting us with that.
Yeah. All right.
I'm going to cut that out.
Dennis,
yeah, I'm not gonna hurt you.
Don't move a muscle. Is that understood? I'm taking that phone. Last time you didn't let me have it, do not move it. I'm taking this phone. Is that understood?
Yeah, you're taking my property there.
I understand that.
Taking my property.
And you almost ruined a kid's life today. So you are in no position to negotiate.
Yeah.
What's the code?
The code to the phone?
I'm not giving it.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm not asking for the code.
We don't need it.
All right. You said I'll try to be, you know, so obviously there's a lot of phone calls here because we're so done texting you. So we just, you know.
We just called you at night.
Recorded it and all that.
Hundreds of people saw it.
Yeah, have you committing crimes on the phone hours and hours worth?
You can say hi if you want to. They all want to see you.
Yeah, say hello.
Say hi.
They've been watching you for months.
Hello.
You said you want to see my boy part. I said sure.
That's right, by the way?
Yeah.
Okay.
You said a picture or on the call tonight? You said, get ready, tell me when you are ready. Okay, here it is, you sent it. You said, did I upset you? And when we see each other, you can touch it and play with it if you want. Maybe do something like this, you said.
What was that? What was this that he said? I forgot which one it was, there were so many.
There were a lot.
No, I don't know.
You said, does it look fun to you? I can't wait to see your girl parts. What do you call your girl parts? And then I said, vaginal.
I can remember if you said that or me. I was like, what?
No, I definitely said vaginal.
Vaginal! How about calling it your kitty when we are talking?
Oh! Kitty!
We got you something!
Yeah, we got you something for the kitty! Wear that or we're calling the cops.
No.
Put it on.
We got an extra small. I know it's gonna be a little big on you. I apologize about that, but I do it.
Hey, Alex. Thumbnail.
Okay. Put it down.
Come on,
Alex. Look. I'm trying to.
Okay. Look, we're gonna.
Can you stand up? We need a picture.
We're gonna take a picture of this.
Hold with the barbecue sauce. Come on.
Let me get my construction thing.
Can you make the peace sign?
Huh?
To the peace sign for it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait a second.
Have the bottle like this.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. All right. Well, hello, kitty. Okay. All right. Then you even said, yeah, back.
Do it.
Yeah. I didn't do it much better than that on the phone.
All right, then you said, do you ever touch your kitty? Why did you mention said, God, dude, you're just pathetic, man.
I mean, yeah, look at that shirt you're wearing. So pathetic you are.
Well, yeah, I'm being threatened here that if I didn't put it on, you're going to call the cops, so...
Oh.
But did we hurt you with, did we threaten you with violence at all?
No, I got hurt.
Okay. How come you said, do you ever touch your kitty? Some girls do and some don't. It's okay either way, but it feels good.
Because I was curious whether or not she did it.
How come you wanted her to stop wearing panties, like, forever?
That's the thing for me. I don't...
A thing for you, but what about her? She's 8.
Yeah, but...
Yeah.
You can say what I want you to wash. You can say it. I'm going to wash your kitty.
I'm just laughing at your shirt.
I'm going to wash your kitty and butt really good when we take a shower together. Goddamn, American dream.
It's like voluntary at this point, so.
Alright. Dude, I'm hungry. Where are the fried pickles at?
Coming.
Fried pick. Okay. Are they delivering?
Yeah.
Okay, cool, cool.
Alright, stand where Jesus is and finish filming.
Alright.
Got it?
Yep.
Let's see.
How can you say, do you think I got you, don't.
I got you.
What are you talking about there?
Whether or not it's my...
Where?
Wherever.
Wherever.
You said it's about the size of a banana.
I'm sure you can get a banana in your mouth. I'm sure it'll be good.
Yeah. I mean, maybe it looks like a banana. I mean, it's small like someone that's yellow. I'm sure you can get a banana in your mouth. I'm sure you'll do good. I guess you fell asleep. Good night, baby girl. Then you say good morning. God, dude. You know, after all this, we've only read 3 days of chats.
And there was more. We just did the worst. You sent a photo and a video of you, Matt. And then you said, did you like it? I deleted it so you wouldn't get in trouble, just in case your mom checked. So she wouldn't get in trouble.
Hey,
manipulation.
That is manipulation. Yeah. So you won't get in trouble. Did you say that with the purpose of trying to... Like, why'd you say you wouldn't get in trouble? You never really talked about you getting in trouble. You really talked about her getting in trouble with this.
Yeah.
You'd say that's manipulative, yes or no?
It probably is. That wasn't the intention. If she wasn't picking up her phone, you know, she'd be in trouble.
So when we showed up, when did you know that it was bullshit? When we showed up, like, when we were saying, hey, we got you a cake for your 60th, when did you know it was bullshit when we took out the barbecue sauce?
No, I recognized my face.
You recognized my face? Even in the sunglasses and the wig. So you were gonna go inside and get your guy.
No.
How come you said come inside?
Well, just so we could talk, not have everybody out here. Because I knew there was people outside.
When did you recognize my face? Before or after you had a bite?
Actually, it was your voice.
Oh.
Yeah, your voice.
So, Lilish, you recognize me?
Huh?
You recognize my voice, Lilish?
That's how he's talking.
Yeah, well, I mean, I recognize you.
He just doesn't know how. He just recognized you.
Yeah. Well, we spent a couple hours together.
Oh, here you are again.
Were you expecting me to drive 1,500 miles from Cotulla to Wisconsin Rapids?
No, I was not expecting that.
So you were kind of suspect about this whole thing, weren't you?
Yeah.
What did you think was the alternative? What were the options? So one, you thought she was real. She thought she was coming. That's why you obviously were texting the whole time. So that was number one. What was the number two thing you thought was going to happen?
That it was a scam. You know.
A scam?
Well.
Like that nobody would show up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh.
And number three, did you ever expect the cops?
No, I didn't expect the cops.
Why's that?
Well, I mean, I figured it may be somebody like y'all, but, you know.
So, did you ever think that it could be him again?
So you seem to catch a right?
Yeah.
What did you think about the people caught on that show?
Some of them just kind of got pulled into this deal, and some of them actually were pretty bad.
But the people that were pretty bad, I think you're worse than every single person Chris Hansen's bum ass caught. You're worse than every single one. He's never decoyed an 8-year-old because he's too much of a lazy but you're worse than every single one. So the people that were bad, when they went to jail, do you think they deserved it?
Some of them, I'm sure they did.
Right. So you also wanted to marry this 8-year-old and...
Yeah, you wanted to take her to Brazil so you could marry her.
That was just talking shit there.
Yeah.
But you were in love with her.
No, not really.
How come you said I love you every night, and you also admitted that you were in love with her to a certain extent when we were here?
Yeah.
So what is it?
I would had affection.
Look me
for
in
her,
the
yeah.
eyes. What is
it? I had affection for her. Yeah.
So you loved her or no?
Well, she was sweet. Or appeared to be sweet.
So did you love her?
Maybe.
Okay.
Well, you said earlier you did. So.
Yeah.
Okay. Then you said, right here, I deleted it so you wouldn't get in trouble. Your mom texts your phone, more when you sent. Then you said stuff like doing laundry or whatever.
You said that you wanted to have her come here while you were doing laundry and you guys could kiss and touch each other in the car. Doing laundry, a bunch of boring shit. We could wait in the car and kiss and touch each other.
Okay.
I said, yeah.
So what's the word for touching an underage kid?
You said make myself come think about you.
What's the word for touching an underage kid? What's the word for it? Okay. So you do admit you did want to move the child, right?
To a certain extent, yeah.
What
certain
do you mean
extent?
To a certain extent?
You admitted you wanted to fuck the girl, man.
Well.
Do you think fucking a girl's
well, yeah.
Okay. So, again.
So what do you mean to a certain extent? You want to reword that? Quit lying.
I probably
do. Yeah. Only if I get to lick it off you. And you were, that was in reference to barbecue sauce. It's, you had a pattern of barbecue sauce. I mean, unless you're just a really unfunny dude, the same joke over and over again gets really bland. So I don't think it was a joke. And, God, you do like Sweet Baby Ray, right?
Yeah.
Do you still like it?
No, good.
Good.
Like I said, probably call it whenever you barbecue it up again.
Okay.
That would be a lot of things in there.
Yeah. In hindsight, maybe you should have done much on it. Anyway.
You said thinking about how you will sound when we are doing it. Would you like to try something new next time we call? So that's proof. So were you really fantasizing about her? So you just lied and said you were turned on thinking about how she would sound? You just lied about that?
I mean, you pretty much admitted to everything.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, here's just a bunch of who blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
So, Dennis, we know where you work. Okay, the picture you sent earlier, like, we had an idea, it said on your Facebook, but the picture you sent earlier, when you were writing that report,
yes.
It said the company on there. So we know exactly where you work. If somebody was a working there that has to commit all these crimes to get underage kids, and it is a crime if you know that they're eight, no matter who it is, do you think they'd be working there? Do you think they should be working there? I mean, you said you're pretty lonely up here, right? You know, prison has a lot of other things. And they love to wrestle people like you.
Why are you
sending
this?
Huh?
You're on the phone with your son while he's having a hard time.
Yeah, it looks more a lot like a mayo than barbecue sauce.
Come on. I'm good.
Yeah, you're evil. Okay. Police are here. You're not getting off this time. You're done. You got so lucky the first time. You're done. Go talk to them.
I need my phone back.
Nope.
It is my property.
How's it going, sir?
Hey, I need my phone back.
So, this man right here admitted to wanting to lure an 8-year-old, pick her up, do something with her with barbecue sauce, yes or no?
Yeah,
okay. And he also has a ton of China. This is his phone. I took it from him because he has on here. So much
you need to look at it.
Please look at it.
He has sent us. We did not screenshot it.
Is it true? Have you sent anything?
Sorry.
Have you sent anything to these people?
Yeah. I mean, I have some on my phone too that I didn't open.
Hold on. Do you have anything on the phone? Yeah. Do you have any phone up everyone? Have a look.
No.
I guess
not. I don't know.
I mean, I can give you a reason to look. You can open it up on my phone.
I can't, I'm not going into this phone unless I have consent or search warrants. If you don't give me consent to do it, based on what I can figure out from these people, they'll seize the phone while the detectives do a search warrant and search it. I'm not threatening you, I'm not trying to coerce you in any way, so can I get consent to search the phone?
Well, I admit it.
You do have consent on this phone.
Then I got off the
telegram. You have it saved, yes or no? On the phone.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm probation parole, are you a registered SO?
Move the chair. You can move the chair. Yeah.
853 up in 10.9 of Texas. Last name spelling is Mary Charles Charles Union Lincoln Lincoln Ocean Union George Henry. First name is Dennis Common Middle Student Tom. Male date of birth is 7/19/61 0719/1961. Okay. All right, Dennis, I'm ready to talk to these folks. You want to come down to the department and talk to me? Tell me what's going on.
My shit.
I don't really have a choice, do I?
At this point, I'd take you to custody based on what we have. I'd prefer to have you talk with me first, though, so. 10-4. Alright.
Can you take my shirt off? It's stuck.
Let's go over to the car. And if I can have
He has a gun in there, sir.
Yeah.
He has a gun.
Yeah. But I'm not going to step
in. In that case, definitely not. I'll need you folks all to hang tight if I get everything.
Sure.
What's that? Boobs
are too
big. Who's trunk? His?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we probably.
I got it. Bro, what did he left the keys inside the truck?
Good dude.